Hey, good morning to everybody. Happy Friday. It's Daryl here. It's bright and freaking early, man. It's 3 a.m. here in Connecticut on the East Coast. Okay, after doing the last video where I talked about the altercation at the gas station, and I did another video just about feet. And I was that was a bad video. I have to apologize. That was a poor choice for a video. But after doing those two videos, I started thinking about all the accidents, broken bones, stitches I've gotten throughout my life. And I had never thought about this before, and I want to talk about this really quick right now, and I want to show you some of them because I never really gave it much thought. I'm 58 years old, and this is the first time I'm really giving it a lot of thought. And I was in the hospital every couple of months. I was very I was always a risk-taking, accident-prone kid. Honestly, just to be completely honest, ever when my dad died when I was 9, looking back now, I think it was a mindset where I was challenging death. Like where I would take chances and say, you didn't get me, I'm still alive. Seriously. And I did it more and more. I lost more people. Like the year I graduated high school, I lost two of my best friends, and I took on more and more risk-taking behavior. And this morning, after doing that video, I started thinking, I had never thought about this, how I had been hurt in altercations and fist fights. And I'm just going to point out a few of them this morning. I had never given this much, and there's some interesting ones. I got three stitches right here, right up here. This was from, I was in some projects drinking with my buddies, 17 or 18 years old. And we were going up there to see girls, like low income housing projects. And I didn't know the girl had a boyfriend. And I got in a fight. And as I was fighting this one guy, this was at night after I'd been drinking, like I said. And I got hit from behind with a chair leg. And as I turned around, the guy hit me again and hit me right here with a chair leg. And here's the best part. I actually ended up taking the chair leg away from him and finishing the fight. I didn't go down. I had a concussion, but I didn't go down. I must have a thick head. Three stitches here. This is from a guy that was wearing a ring that hit me right. I don't know if you can see him there. Three stitches there. Here's a really interesting one. It broke my nose. My nose has been broke three times. I had cuts on it too, from getting in fights. The first time it got broke, I got in a fight on roller skates, and I didn't know the other guy was a black belt. And I got into this altercation. Like I talked in the last video, I had never swung on anybody before, so I walked up to the guy puffing my chest up, and he just hauled off and hit me, man. He was a black belt, and it not only broke my nose, but it broke the orbital. I think it's called an orbital disc. It broke the bone underneath my eye. The doctor told me that if I get double vision, to call him right away because my eye might sink down into the socket. He actually broke my face. My feet went flying up in the air on the roller skates. I landed on my back, and he ran out of the roller skating rink like an idiot. I was all angry. I took my skates off. I ran out after him. My friends were saying, "Daryl, don't go. Don't go out. Your nose is broke. Don't go outside." And I ran outside, and I ran right into a half circle of him and seven of his friends. These guys were from a gang of Italian guys called the Town Plot in Waterbury, Connecticut. And they just I went down swinging, but they just started wailing on me. Here's an interesting thing on too. The guy that picked me up off the sidewalk and brought me to the hospital was another one of the guys that I had been in a fight with in elementary school, and we became friends after a while. And he's the one that actually picked me up off the sidewalk and brought me to the hospital. So that one. Oh, mine. Here's one. I broke this pinky. This pinky, you can see it's still hanging off to this side. This is an interesting one. I actually was in a fight, and I swung a right, and then I went to swing a left, and I think it got caught. He was wearing a heavy silver chain, like I don't know what it was, almost like a chain link chain hanging from around his neck. He was a motorcycle guy. And my finger got caught in the chain, and it just bent my finger backwards, and it broke my finger here and here. When I pulled my hand back, my finger was actually hanging backwards. It was actually broke down and hanging backwards. It didn't. I was so much adrenaline, I didn't even feel it. And I was still trying to fight with my pinky flopping around. And I got it straightened after that. Next video. I have more. Next video. Here's one of the worst ones I ever got. You can see this arm is badly, it was badly broke. These two bones went on top of these two. You can see that it's still badly broken. And that's just the ones, that's just the injuries from here up. I'll talk more about them in coming videos. It's not worth it. It's not worth it. I'm surprised I made it this long. I'm surprised I actually made it to 58 years old. And my mindset now is just is one of just let it go, walk away if I can. It's a miracle that I've made it this far after the life that I led. Recovery is possible. I've been clean and sober for 17 and a half years since October 23rd of 2006. Recovery is possible. Have a good Friday.